Hello all, welcome back to the module 5. And in this session, we continue the design of arithmetic circuits, especially the parallel multiplier. Okay. So this is the session where we deal with designing a parallel multiplier. Okay. So figure below shows, this is the figure, okay, which is a block diagram of a parallel multiplier. As indicated by the arrows on the diagram, okay, 4 bits from the accumulator. Okay, so what we do is exactly this is basically an 8-bit register. Okay, sorry, 9-bit register basically. Okay, okay. So starting from least significant being 0 and the most significant being 8. Okay, so here 4 bits of this 9-bit, we call it as something like an accumulator. Okay, then if we are multiplying 2 4-bit number, we are sure that the product will be 8-bit. Okay, so that's why the 0 to 7 in this accumulator is nothing but what, the product. Okay, and 4 5 6 7 is the higher bits of this accumulator or the product. That will be, this is the 4 bits that is added along with the 4 bits of the multiplicand. I can consider that one shift, one register will be there, that will be a having the multiplicand value. Okay, so 4 bits from the accumulator, 4 bits from the multiplicand register are connected to the adder inputs. The 4 sum bits and the carry out from this adder again goes back to the accumulator. Okay, so meaning 4 5 6 7 accumulator bits along with the 4-bit multiplicand bits are added. The sum will be going and sitting again back in the 7 6 5 4 bits along with the carrying, that is going and sitting in 8-bit. Okay, so this is what really we have. So we have total 9-bit accumulator in which 8 bits are used to store final product. Okay, we have a 1 4-bit adder which takes the inputs from a multiplicand and also inputs from the higher bits of accumulator, and whatever the sum that it generates will go back to the accumulator along with the carry. Okay, and then the least significant accumulator, that is the bit 0, 1, 2, 3, will be storing initially the multiplier value. Okay, we'll take an example and see what exactly this happens. Okay, so out of 9-bit, 4-bit is used to store the multiplier value initially. Okay, then the total 9 bits is acting as an accumulator, out of which 8 bits from 0 to 7 bits act as a product. Then this particular register is synchronous with the clock. Okay, after every clock pulse, it will perform. Okay, so now there is a controller part. Okay, wherein 2 inputs are there for that. 3 inputs. One is the clock, which is synchronous with this registers. Another 2 are the start signal and the M. And M is nothing but what, the least significant bit of the multiplier. Okay, so what is M? So M, we typically say that this is the least significant bit of multiplier. M is basically the LSB of the multiplier. So it is a multiplier MSB of the multiplier. Okay, so this is what. Yes. So this is the start. Whenever the first start signal is given to the controller, then it will generate appropriate signals. Okay, so it will first check the least significant bit of the multiplier. Okay, then it will try to give the corresponding signals to this accumulator. Okay, so that means whether it has to add, AD means it is an add output, SH means it is a shift, load means it is a initial loading. Okay, so this is what is really happening. Okay, so we'll try to see which signal will be generated based on what input signal. Once the multiplication is done, then the controller will generate a done signal. Okay, so this is with respect to the block diagram, wherein the adder adds the 4 bits of accumulator and the 4 bits of the multiplicand, and the result will go back and sits in the accumulator where we get the 4 inputs, that is 7 6 5 4 bits. 8-bit is used for the carry out. Okay, for intermediate carries. The least significant bits initially will hold the multiplier, and after the multiplication is done, the 8 bits in the accumulator, that is from 0 to 7, will hold the product. Okay, So when this particular addition or the shift or the load should happen, that is decided by the controller. And that's what we'll try to see in the next slides. Yeah. So now the adder calculates the sum of its inputs, and when an add signal occurs, the adder outputs are stored in the accumulator by the next rising edge of the clock. This is what is stored, thus causing the multiplicand to be added to the accumulator. An extra bit at the left end of the product register, that is the 8th bit, that is the 9th bit basically, the bit 8, temporarily stores a carry which is generated when the multiplicand is added to the accumulator. Because the lower 4 bits of the product multiplier is initially unused, anyway, we'll take up with an example and then we'll try to see what exactly this means. Okay, so this is what is really happening. As each multiplier bit is used, it is shifted out to the right end. We'll see again in the next thing. Okay. So before we go with this particular explanation, what we'll try to do is we'll try to see how exactly, how exactly the multiplication happens. Okay. So what we'll try to do now is we are trying to multiply. Okay. So we are trying to multiply 11 and 13. Okay. So we are trying to multiply 11 and 13. It is something like 11 into 13 or 13 into 11, whichever. So 11 is our multiplier. Okay. That's what multiplier. And 13 is the multiplicand. Okay. This is my multiplicand. Okay. And you know that where exactly this multiplicand will go and sit. Okay. So multiplicand, if I'm not wrong, multiplicand will be held by, or it will be held by one of the 4-bit register. I can say that this is my 4-bit multiplicand register. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. This is the least significant of the multiplicand, and this is the most significant of the multiplier. M0, 1, 2, and 3. Okay. Always, whenever an addition is happening, the output of this register will be acting as an input of this. Okay, this is what we say. Okay, so this is the multiplicand. Multiplicand is 13, we say. So 13 is 12, 1, 1, 0, 1 is our 13. And as I said, multiplier is stored in the least significant bit of the multiplier. It is 11. 11 is 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, so accumulator, least significant 4 bits will hold the multiplier 1011. So when it initially, when it stores, that is the least significant 4 bit stores the multiplier value, then the higher 5 bits will be loaded with 0. Okay. So when the start is enabled, the very first thing the controller will ensure is it will enable the load signal. Load the higher 5 bits with zeros, that is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and the lower 4 bits with the multiplier. And what is the multiplier value now? It is 11, which is nothing but what, 1011 in binary. And the multiplicand is 1101. Yes, this is what it really does. Okay, and that is what we are seeing there in the that particular slide now. Okay, so we'll directly go to that example. Okay, so now we can see that here what we have. Yes. So this is the least significant bit of the accumulator. Okay. This is accumulator 0 bit, the first bit, the second bit, and the third bit. Okay. This is the 4th bit. This is the 5th bit. This is the 6th. This is the 7th. And this is the 8th. Is it clear? Yes. So when the start signal is given to the controller, it will enable the load. So initial contents of product registers are loaded. Whenever a load signal is generated from the controller, it loads the accumulator with the least significant bits as multiplier 1011. Okay. And the most significant 5 bits. Okay. With all zeros. Okay. This is what the initial thing comes. Next, it has one of the other input, M. M is nothing but what I said. It is the least significant of the multiplier. Okay. So there is one important aspect of the least significant bit of the multiplier. Okay. If the multiplier bit, that is the least significant bit in the accumulator or the multiplier, if it is 1, okay, we add multiplicand to the with the accumulator. Okay, so we know that 7654 are the inputs, I mean, are the accumulator values, and 1101 is the, which is the 13, that is the multiplicand. Okay, whenever the least significant bit of the multiplier is 1, we add accumulator content along with the multiplicand. Okay, so this is what we'll do. Okay, so the least significant bits are not affected anything. Okay, we are trying to add only these two numbers. Okay, 01 is 1, 000, 01 is 1, 01 is 1, this is 0. Okay, so that means the carry out that is coming out of this is 0. That is why my MSC, this is my carry, that is 0. Okay, so this is the latest value that we have after adding multiplier with the multiplicand. Sorry, it is not the multiplier with the multiplicand. Sorry, it is the multiplicand plus the accumulator, and that too bits 7654. Since the initially my accumulator content is 0, so only the multiplicand will be added here. Okay, so when m is equal to 1, we add. After addition, we just shift the entire accumulator content towards right by one shift. That means this one will go here, this 0 will go here, this one will come here, this one will come here, this 0 will go here, this one will come here, this one will come here, this 0 will come here. Okay. And what is this? This is basically a carry in that we have here. Okay. This is what is happening now. Yes. So what we did, we loaded the accumulator, initially the least significant 4 bits with the multiplier and the 5 most significant bit with all zeros. And then we'll be, the controller will be checking for 1 now. When m is equal to 1, it will add the multiplicand with the accumulator and then it will shift by 1. Okay. So this is with respect to 1. So after shifting, once again, it will be checking for m value. Once again, my m value is 1. So that's why you add multiplicand again, which is 13, to the same 7654 bits of the accumulator. Now the latest value of 7654 of accumulator is 0110. Add this 4 bits will be retained as it is 1011. 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 01, 1 plus 0, 1 plus 1, 2, 01, and this is 1. Okay, this is the carry that will be going. Yes. And after addition, shift. After shifting, you can see that this is going here. Okay. And the last the most significant bit in this, after shifting, it will be loaded with 0. Okay. Okay. After shift, the most significant bit, that is 8 bit, is loaded with 0. Okay. Now, so first time we encountered 1, second time we encountered 1. Third time, we are encountering the least significant bit of the multiplier, that is 0. Now, when it is 0, you have to do only the shift. No addition comes here. Okay, so that's the importance. So skip addition because m is equal to 0. So when m is equal to 1, you add the multiplicand to the accumulator, then you shift. When the multiplier least significant bit is 0, you just shift it. Okay, I'm not doing any addition. So what I'm trying to do is this one, I'm shifting here. This one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. Okay. Then what should be added to the most significant bit of the accumulator? Put a 0 there. Okay. So 3 times. And for the 4th time, I am checking the multiplier least significant bit. That is 1 again. Add again the multiplicand to accumulator with respect to 7654 bits. And then once again you add, and the most least significant bit doesn't alter. Then you add 1100 1 here. Once again shift. This here, this here, this here, this here. And for the most significant bit, add 0 now. Okay. Then we try to stop. Why we have to stop? On what basis? That depends upon how many times we have encountered the multiplicand bits. In other words, how many shift I have done? I have done shift 1, shift 2, shift 3, and shift 4. After 4 shift, the multiplication process is complete. The controller will generate a done signal now. Why done it should signal? Why only after 4? Because we know that the multiplier bits are total number of multiplier bits are only 4. So, okay. So 4 times shift or 4 times checking the multiplier least significant bits and then deciding. Okay. Now you can see that this is the final product now value that is stored in the accumulator. That is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1. If I try to decode this in terms of decimal, okay, this is the binary one unit place. This is 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. 28 plus 8, 136 plus 4, 140 plus 2, 142. This is 143. You can see that 143 is added here. Okay, this is how exactly the multiplication process happens. And this is what is actually said in this previous two slides. Okay, the adder calculates the sum of its inputs, and when an add signal occurs, the adder outputs are stored in the accumulator by the next rising edge of the clock, thus causing the multiplicand to be added to the accumulator. Okay, so adder basically, okay, so whenever the M bit is checked by the controller, it generates add. So the adder adds the accumulator value along with the multiplicand and stores back the result along with the carry in the accumulator itself. An extra bit at the left end of the product register temporarily stores any carry 4, which is generated when the multiplicand is added to the computer accumulator. Because the lower 4 bits of the product register are initially unused, we will store the multiplier in this location instead of a separate register. That's why in the lower 4 bits of the accumulator, we try to store the multiplier. As each multiplier bit is used, it is shifted out of to the right end of the register to make room for the additional product bits. Okay, so after checking the least significant every time, that bit is lost so that the giving a provision for the product bits. Okay, the load signal loads the multiplier into the lower 4 bits of the accumulator and at the same time clears the upper 5 bits. Okay, the shift signal causes the contents of the product register to be shifted one place to the right when the next rising clock edge occurs. The control circuit puts out the proper sequence of add and shift signals after a signal start is equal to 1 has been received. If the current multiplier bit is 1, the multiplicand is added to the accumulator followed by right shift. If the multiplier bit is 0, the addition is skipped and only the right shift occurs. Sorry. The multiplication example at the beginning of this section is reworked, and this is what it has been shown here. Okay. And the same thing. So initially the accumulator is loaded with this multiplier with the least significant 4 bits, clearing all this. Then depending upon the least significant bit of this accumulator, which we call it as a multiplier least significant bit. Okay. If it is 1, add the multiplicand and then shift by 1 along with the carry that you are storing. Yes. Again, if 1, add the multiplicand and shift. If the M bit is 0, then you do only the shift. Okay. So now after that, you can take any 4-bit number and you can do. If your number exceeds 4 bits, then you have to go with 1-bit extra register. Okay. So this is with respect to, limitation is with respect to the multiplicand and the multiplier being the 4 bits. That is one of the things. Okay. So once we have all these things, then we can go for writing a state graph for this multiplier control. Multiplier controller. Not for the operation, it is for the control. Okay. So initially again, so we have S0 as the initial state or the reset state. This is for the controller. We're trying to design a controller for the arithmetic circuits. Okay. So ST bar means ST is 0. ST bar means it is 0. ST means it is 1. If start ST bar is 0 means valid means what? Yes, that means the start signal is not generated. So B in the same state, what is done? Done is the output signal. Okay, so done is the output signal that is generated by the controller. Okay, so input is start. So it will retain the same state. Once I get the start signal, then enable the load. Okay, so we are in the controller part now. Okay, this is my controller. This is my controller, right? Okay. So when it receives the start signal is equal to 1, then it will generate a load signal. This is what I said in the initial case, right? It will generate a load signal. That means it loads the accumulator lower significant bits with a multiplier, and then the higher 5 bits it resets. Okay. After that, it comes to S1 state. At S1, it will check for M. If M is 1, it gives the add, generates the add and give it to the addition. So add is generated and the adder will add the accumulator and the multiplicand and it will store back in the accumulator. Okay. After that, the control will go to the state S2. Okay. When it is in S2, it is ensured that addition is in process. Once the addition is done, it will generate the shift. Okay. The controller has to ensure that in which state it has to generate what particular signal. Okay. So add is output, load is output. That's fine. Okay. So at initial state, if start is not enabled, it will be there in the initial state. If start signal is coming, it will enable the load and it will go to S1 state. And at S1, it will check for M. If M is 1, then it will go to the next state by enabling add. Meanwhile, the adder will add the accumulator and that. And at when the controller in S2, it without any input signal, it ensures that it has to shift and goes to S3. If at S1, if it finds M is equal to 0, it will directly do only the shift. So add and shift if M is equal to 1, or if not only shift, it enables if it is this case. And again at S3, it will check M for 4 times because multiplier is of 4 bit. And the same thing it will do. M is equal to 1, it will enable the add signal, goes to the S4, and then it will enable the shift and goes to the S5. If not, if M is equal to 0, it will directly go to S5 with enabling shift. Same case holds good in S5. It will go to S6 and then S7. If M is equal to 1, add and shift. If not, it will go to S7 directly by shift for shifting if it is M is equal to 0. From here, it is done. At S9, it has completed the 4 shift operation. Finally, it will generate done and come to the initial state. Okay. So finally, it will generate a done. Done is equal to 1 means the multiplication process is completed, okay, and the accumulator is typically having the result, okay, and finally the result will be stored in this, okay, which ensures that this accumulator not only holds the multiplier and initially reset values of zeros, finally after the multiplication process is done, the 8 bits will store the product. Okay, this is our design of parallel multiplier is done and a controller part of it. Okay, so in the next session we'll take up the design of divider circuit. Yeah, thank you.